on the threes.
All right, everyone, let's run through a quick last look at what we can expect for tonight. Now, we do have a moderate risk of some severe weather out over through Shreveport. That is pretty strong language coming in from the Storm Prediction Center this morning, and it sounds like they may even be expanding this outlook coming up at the 7 o'clock advisory that they put out. So we may see some of these numbers changing around a little bit. Regardless, though, there's a corridor right here for a little bit closer to home that runs up through Jefferson Davis, Rapides, maybe even into of Voiles and parts of Evangeline. I think that's going to be our tornado corridor today, where we'll have to watch that area closely. The rest of us are going to be dealing with very, very strong winds, not just through the day, but picking up 60, 70 mile an hour winds as we get further into the night tonight. 78 degrees for your high today. Today's forecast, we're pretty quiet during the daytime outside of those winds. It'll be warm. It's going to be muggy. It'll be very, very windy. Highs get up to around 78. Through the evening, we drop down to around 63 for your overnight low. And a quick look at the timing and the threats that we're looking at with this system. Biggest thing is going to be damaging winds, winds up to about 60, 70 miles an hour. What to look for today? If we get thunderstorms out ahead of this squall line, it will increase the tornado threat a little bit overnight, and we'll maybe lower the capability of some of the higher end winds. But regardless, we're looking at damaging winds today. Pay attention to the skies. If you start to see some sunshine, pay attention to the radar, because those thunderstorms will be no joke if they start to get going. The hail threat's going to stay fairly minimal out there as that front moves through. Again, that could change if we see some thunderstorms developing out ahead of it. It will be important to tune back in tonight with Rob as we start to fine tune the final moments of this forecast. Regardless of sunshine or not, I think that the marginal chance for a little bit of street flooding right when that front is pushing through. But everyone should be inside through that time period and not out on the roadways dealing with flood. That will start to clear up pretty quickly as we go through the rest of the day. So Saturday evening, things aren't going to be looking too bad. This should all be over by about mid-morning. And again, we do have some pretty active weather on the way for tonight.